Hallelujah. Let me hear your hands. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. I like dancing. I want to see you moving. Yes, so. Ha. Hallelujah. First Sunday of the month. Hey, you have to be grateful. We are praising God with our dance, eh? Our hands. Hallelujah. Glory.
You make me wonder,
Baba.
I wonder.
You make me
Living God.
Living God.
The way maker.
The way maker.
Make the way for me today.
Make the way
for my family today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Living God, the way maker. Make the way for me. Make the way for my family today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Make the way, make the way, make the way, make the way, make the way for me and my family today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Living God, you are the way maker. Make the way for me. Make the way for my family. Make the way for this church. In the mighty name of Jesus. Make the way. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus.
Gentleness and the warfare can be more ready. You will close yourself.
say power. I say I will remain the same. You are a liar.
Yeah. made first class. The mountain top was in Nigeria. First class, 19. How do you get it? Yes. No diversion. Focus on the study. From the study to the church to prayer. All this dancing, this looking and all. So one thing first. Once you miss that opportunity, it's not coming back again. Don't want. You can hear me and hear me. Anyone that is looking at the achievement of his father or her father or her mother, and we know what, we see the way later. You have to make a man yourself. You have to make your father, your mother, their brother. If you cannot succeed, if your sentence is not starting from where your father and your mother's success stop, you are a failure. Where your father and your mother's success, where they stop, maybe they will have first degree, and you have said, I will target from you, are a failure. Close your eyes. Say,
thank you.
For the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your soul. For it is the blood that maketh an atonement for your soul. Verse 14. For it is the life of all flesh. The blood of it is for the life thereof. Therefore, I said unto the children of Israel, ye shall eat the blood of no manner of flesh. For the life of all flesh is in the blood thereof. Whosoever eateth it shall be cut off. The issue of blood. But the importance of blood is the lifeline. The lifeline. Your marriage is connected with God. It's a lifeline. That is why the powers of darkness that you want to free somebody is sacrificing. Without the blood, there is no life. And that is why I want to talk about the issue of blood shortly. Because your mind is connected with blood. Your work, your career, everything you are doing. Everything. The issue of blood is incessant flowing of blood without ceasing, like a tap. The blood is flowing. And the essence is to drain out life. To drain out life. If it didn't stop, it will drain out life. The blood that is flowing to your career, to your marriage, to your whole body, it is just draining out, the person will soon expire. So the blood is connected. As you are sitting there now, if there is no blood, can you see that? No. No. Without the blood, you can't walk. That is why you are stealing from somebody, the blood will cry. Because without the blood, the person cannot walk to get money. There is power in the blood. Luke chapter 9. Luke chapter 9. Stopping the issue of blood. Luke chapter 9. Luke chapter 9. I read verses 43 to 47. Luke chapter 9. I read from 43 to 47. Before they crucified,
any evil connection
between my blood and evil altar, it is connected by fire. Evil connection between my blood and evil altar, it is connected by fire. It is connected by fire. Evil connection. Evil connection between my blood being disconnected. In Jesus' name we pray. Any power assigned to drain life out of me. Assigned to drain life out of my marriage. Assigned to drain life out of my career. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to pray.
poverty.
There is nothing in your life that is not connected with God. Have you ever sat down and asked, why are these evil people sacrificing? Why? They want the blood. Remember that it was the sacrifice on the cross of Calvary that brought you out of bondage.
Yes, sir.
And they also sacrificed. And that sacrifice from the cross of Calvary covers everything about your life. Is that not so? Satan. You're going out, you're coming in, connected to the blood. Look chapter 80, verse 23. And a woman has had an issue of blood 12 years, which has spent all her living upon physician, neither could he be healed of any. Came behind him and touched the border of his garment, and immediately her issue of blood was ceased. And Jesus said, who touched you? When all denied, Peter and they that were within said, Master, the multitude trust thee and praise thee, says thou touchest me. And Jesus said, somebody has touched me. For I perceive that righteousness is gone out of me. And when the woman saw that she was not healed, she came trembling and falling down before him. She declared unto him before all the people for what all she had touched him and how she was. Woman, the blood has been draining out of her life for 12 years. I don't know how many years you have stayed in your problem, but let me tell you, it's connected to the blood. Power is draining life out of you because you are looking for people to save. Your prayer life is going down. You have become apathetic. Fear is all over you. It's all draining life out of you. Close your eyes. Anything broken into my life to drain life out of me. Why are you crying? Why are you complaining? They mourn, they cry, they complain, this draining life out of you. They are pushing up blame. It's my mother, it's my things, it's my wife, it's my husband. It's draining life out of you. You take the responsibility. Like David did. Prophet, I am the one. And he confessed. Look at this one. Never he hide anything from you. The Bible said she told Jesus everything. You are hiding something. There is nothing in you that Jesus does not know. When it is time for you to tell the prophet, this is what I have, you can't tell. So if I say now, how will he feel? If I say now, I will discipline. If I say now, it's like, oh, no. I remember one old woman in those days, some 15, 16 years ago, when I was in the state in Nigeria, she came. She said, Pastor, they fired the man. I said, what's the fire? They wanted to kill the firstborn, the bread woman. She was a witcher. So they wanted to kill your son. It's the same thing. They say you have been eating other people's head. They say she never had anything. They say, where are you? They say she has been keeping them and see the cow. She never ate it. And they gave her to eat. And they gave her to eat. And when they now demand them, say, where's your own share? They carry the king and say, no, that one is fast. It's your own now. You have to donate. And the man that is the fires on his head was going about looking for women, drinking, and doing everything. Whereas this woman said, no, you can't kill my first one. He's the one taking care of you. She ran to the church. And she said everything. And God delivered. But you will be quiet. I will say. And you know, you always attend worship meeting, you keep quiet. You know, you are doing things that are not in conformity with the word of God, you keep quiet. Then you want God to answer you. It's not possible. You open up to Him, He knows. The Bible says, with your mouth, what you do? You confess. With your heart, you believe. But you don't confess, since you don't believe. I am praying for you now. Whatever area is in your life that the enemy is using to teach you, the Holy Spirit will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus will set you free in the name of Jesus. The woman came to Jesus and told Jesus everything. As you are, we're coming to church this morning. What is in your mind? You are just coming into church to worship. You have not told us, oh Lord, I am going to be. This is what I want. No agenda, nothing. Then that will you receive. Your prayer will be answered right from your house before you get to church. This woman, she had her own. I want the issue of blood to what? To stop. And she talked it. She got it and it stopped. But you, just going to church is a normal thing. It's a routine. Every Sunday, routine. How will the problem go? When before you leave your house, you have no desire for that. So this is what I want the Lord to do for me this Sunday. This is what I want the Lord to do for me as I'm going to this program. You don't have it. You need to have it. That is why we are diverted. When you come to the church or fellowship, you are diverted. You look in the other way, look in the other way, say, close your life, don't close your life. Not knowing that the God you are worshiping, He is the Spirit. You can't see Him if you're naked now. It is when you go into the Spirit, close your eyes. Say,
anything in my foundation, I send to trouble my destiny.
In Jesus' name, let us say this Is that not so? They that know their God, they will do what?
Yes.
She knew Jesus. That was why she knew. Others were there. Others were there. Others were there. They are born there to see how he can speak. They are born here to see. And they say he's the son of the carpenter. The others say he's the son of God. Let them not see. They have no agenda. They are not desiring anything. She knew that this is Jesus, the son. Do you know him? Do you know Jesus? Have you surrendered your life to Jesus? It's very important. Going to church does not make you born again. No. It is when you know him and you surrender your life to him. That is when you are missing from him. Number two, she knew what says. She knew she has issue of blood. She knew she had been going from her palace to sorcerer to everywhere. She knew. And there was no solution. And she knew and said that she was not right. And she came to Jesus. Number three, she was concentrating on Jesus Christ. No diversion. The Bible said, look unto him. And she was looking at Jesus. She was not looking at the apostles at all. She was looking at Jesus. There were crowds. There was no diversion at all. Concentrate, concentrate on Jesus. Number three, she opened up. She opened up to Jesus. But she don't open up. But she don't know that God knows everything about you. There are some that God wants them to open their mouth and confess, but they don't want to confess. They don't want to confess. David confessed, I am the one. I committed adultery. I killed him. Right. And he asked for forgiveness, Lord. Remember that whatever the sin you commit, it will find us out one day. One day the sin will find you out. And Satan is waiting. Number four, she believed. Yes, this is the Son of God, the one who can heal. She believed, she had faith. Unfailing faith. She had it. And she made up her mind. That day, she must go. He must be healed. Number five. She was leaning on the word of God, leaning, holding on. Say, come to me, all ye that what? Labor and every day, I will give you rest. So you have come to Jesus. There is nothing he cannot do. Remember that the issue of blood is like a tap you open. You open it, and it will be flowing continually. And if it is not stopped, life will be drained out of that person. Number seven, what step did this woman, what step did he take to get the healing, from the Lord Jesus Christ? Number seven, he stood up. Nobody pushing, he stood up. Going to the Lord to receive. element of your family, there will be problem. Children will be stubborn, head, disobedient, and there will be no peace in the house. If they are draining the element of your marriage, the husband and the wife will be back in each other. If they are draining the element of your finance, you cannot balance. You cannot show what achievements you have gotten. Look, you are having money. If you are drinking that out of your body, sickness. Sickness. Whatever will not give you comfort is an issue of love. Whatever will not make you happy is an issue of love. Whatever is keeping victory from your life is an issue of love. Whatever is not enabling you to be civilized is an issue of love. And I pray this morning that the power that I'm drinking that out of you of that in the name of Jesus Christ. The most important thing we must do for us to get the power to stop this power is to be connected with Jesus Christ. The most important thing we can do for us to be connected with the power to stop the issue of God is to know who you are. Who are you? You know yourself. Let me tell you. If you are not connected with Jesus, the world is about to. Devil has no friend. He will waste the blessing. Judas Iscariot was with Jesus. Like you are coming to church. But he didn't know Jesus. If you name Jesus, he will not betray you. If you name Jesus, he will be obedient. Because Jesus has won him. But it's very simple. There's nobody who died and said, I'm going to question the heavens who gave me to you not to die. There's nobody who's already dead that go and say, I will question the prophet who said nothing will happen to me. Let go. That's the wisdom. I am praying the wisdom will not waste in the name of Jesus. The question is, what is the problem in your life? It's connected with the Lord. It's connected with the Lord. And we've been draining it away. Draining it away. We become powerless in prayer. We cannot fast. Because you have awesome and the power to your life. And without praying, without fasting, can this one go away? This one, power. Think about it. What is the problem you are passing through? What is the power behind it? What is the tool they are using? What is it in your life that is connected to them that they are using? Oh Lord, this one, reveal to me the secret of the problem I'm passing through. Expose the power behind it to me. Expose the power. Reveal to me. Expose the power. The issue of Lord. Stop it. Oh Lord, arise in your mercy. Let there be a visitation to you. And if you are not giving your life to Jesus Christ, there's no way you can stop the issue of God. You don't have the power. There's no one way that has power. It's dedicated authority. Either from Jesus Christ or from the devil. And the one of the devil is the people. Expose every evil work of darkness in my life. What is the source of my problem? Who is the captain of the enemy's army? Pursue my life. Once you don't have Jesus, you have lost a lot of things. If you want to come to Jesus, you say, Lord Jesus, I have mercy on me. Tell the Lord Jesus what you have done. I'm asking to forgive you, and he will forgive you. In Jesus' name we pray. Close your eyes. If you know that you are living an epileptic spiritual life, today you are alive, the next day you are no spiritual life.
Just lay your right hand on your chest and pray like this. Say, powers. Say it again.
Powers. I'm trying to enslave me spiritually. You are a liar. Die. Draw.
Jesus' name we pray.
Every blood sacrifice
contesting with my success.
Oh, God. traders.
Marriage traders.
Say the name.
Marriage traders.
Assigned to take off.
Assigned to take off.
The joy of my marriage.
The joy of my marriage.
Marriage traders. Assigned to take off. The joy of my marriage. You are a liar.
Lord, I am asking that by
while we are in public assembly, have you said we are not going to? Your word cannot return to you void. Whatever is making them, turning them back at the head of ritual, let it die in the name of Jesus Christ.
Continually by fire, in the name of Jesus.
Father, let them be disconnected from evil places of darkness and be elevated to divine places in the name of Jesus.
Praise God.